You're very
you're very prolific and seem to put out songs very quickly. What's your secret?
Gotcha.
Dyslexic. I'm in trouble, take me to the station. Put the cuffs on me.
Austin Corini. I'm a singer, songwriter, producer, mixer, master my own music. I like to think I'm a little funny. I play ice hockey and I love my fans and I love God. I would describe my music as music with soul that you can feel with a bit of trap and R&B. You can also hear the hints of what I was inspired by as a child, so Journey, Queen, Michael Jackson. If I put all of the taste of everything I've been inspired by in my life into my music to create my own sound, it's what I really believe makes it unique. So I wouldn't necessarily compare it to another artist, but I feel like it has a lot of strength and it has that R&B trap feel with some soul. And so Gravity was something that was written during definitely some of the hardest times in my life, and something for me as a human being, especially as a writer, and I want to encourage other people, even if it's just writing a poem or something or journaling, writing what you're going through and how you're feeling is important. And sometimes people are afraid to, especially with music, because they feel like, well, down the road, you know, I might not feel that way anymore. But it's important to have that documentation of how you feel at a certain time and being able to express that. And for me, that whole album of Gravity was that, of just me releasing, you know, my experiences of being homeless and just dealing with certain like abandonment issues and problems in my life, and you know, going through, you know, early 20s, my process of becoming who I am and a man, and reflecting on the mistakes I've made in my life and not liking who I used to be when I was touring and how I used to treat people. This music that I'm writing is kind of explaining my turning point and, you know, the fact that life gave me a second chance and the people that loved me are what drove me to actually change and be a better person and start really loving people more than I love myself. So I just hope that albums like Gravity reflect that. I walk alone through the night. Artists who come from nothing, people who are down and out and keep their faith in God and keep their faith in themselves and keep pushing, and that they get their success from that. Like, maintaining success from already established success is hard work, no doubt, but building it yourself from nothing is like a whole nother level that I respect, because I'm coming from nothing, you know what I mean? So that's what really inspires me. Jesus inspires me, the way he loved people. I mean, regardless of what you believe in him, just the way that he loves people, that's how I want to love people. I mean, songwriters like Bruno Mars, Ed Sheeran, Kurt Cobain, extremely inspired by Freddie Mercury, Michael Jackson, the way that he took hold of his career and changed music forever. I mean, those are my main inspirations. Gravity. It's super different, you know, being in a band and being part of that road life and that grind versus like a studio grind, where I've just been kind of focusing on my writing and getting better as a writer because I want to be able to compete with the rest of the industry. It's a whole different kind of lifestyle, but it's all in the music. So I'm still enjoying it, but it's different not being with the boys and like going to certain things or interviews or events and like, you know, going alone, you know, it's crazy. But I'm not really alone, because a lot of times my wife Shannon comes with me, so you know, she keeps me sane, because I know I can be weird and be myself around her and stuff, so that helps. I loved the tied music and I loved doing that, and it was an extension of me. When you're solo, you really get to kind of dive into, okay, what music do I really want to do? If I could choose any music, you know, and really dig into my heart, what I want to say in my music, and I can say whatever I want, I can, it's special, and it kind of becomes more of like a special art that you appreciate. So both things are beautiful, but they're different types of appreciation. They're different types of like euphoria. Like, it's really an amazing experience being a part of music. So it's different, but I've loved every bit of it. So right now I feel like I have the opportunity to take control of what I really want to do, And at the end of the day, my end goal is to build an entire empire. It's not just to get signed and be this artist and put out songs. Like, I want to be a songwriter. I want to sign people. I want to not just sign people, but like give people opportunity who are like out here, feel like they got no chance to get discovered and they got raw talent. Even if it's someone like homeless, like, and they're just singing their heart out. Like, that is ultimately what I want to do. So I'm kind of trying to put myself into a position where I could release my music first and establish myself independently and show people that I can make those numbers happen and that I can make an impact, not just on the industry, but on the world. So that then when I start getting business with people and start working with people and maybe a label opportunity, there's more of like a vision, so people know what I'm trying to do and know what I'm about, rather than, oh, here's this kid that sings and he wants to get signed. You know, I want to establish myself and really show my quality to people like that and really build a team that is not just like any other team, something that I really am patient with and put my time into, and, you know, a team that could really change the world and, you know, bring love back into music and everything, because we need it. We need it everywhere, especially right now in this world. So I'm just kind of praying and just meditating on that and being patient and waiting for the right opportunity. So, yeah. Baby, you got me like don't you stop loving me. Don't quit loving me. Just stop loving it, babe. So for my OnlyFans, I've been using it to release exclusive music and to release music before actual set release for like the public. So if you want to hear like a song before it's dropped, you can hear it on my OnlyFans. Even like entire albums, I'm going to be doing a podcast on there with some of my friends and doing vlog videos and acoustic videos and all kinds of stuff. Just stuff to really get close with my fans and showing you guys behind the scenes, like of a music video set, and you know, when I'm doing shows, take you behind set on tour and kind of give my OnlyFans fans an opportunity to see the music industry from a real up close personal view, if that makes sense. At the same time, is using it as a platform to be able to release things to my fans exclusively, so that those who are super supportive of me and extra close and really believe in me have that ability and that advantage of seeing that stuff, you know what I mean? And a lot of it will be free, you know, and the subscription itself is free, and I'm just doing specific paid posts. For the most part, my most important thing to me is getting my fans to understand who I am as a person and to get that up close personal exclusive. Instead of being played like a violin, what do I... Well, honestly, ever since I started my independent career, I've been writing a song a day. My buddy Danny gave me advice over in the UK. Shout out Danny Shaw and Will Sims, amazing songwriters, beautiful people. Danny taught me, like, because he's the best songwriter I've ever met personally. So he was basically telling me, honestly, dude, just write a song a day. Write a song a day, but get all your bad ideas out and get used to your songwriting capability. So I started doing that. And that's what's given me the ability to post so often and do like two back-to-back albums. And I'm kind of taking advantage of the fact that I put all this time into recording and writing and becoming a good enough writer to where I think, okay, like, this music's now ready to go out, so that I can now kind of repay my fans for all that time they had to wait while I was writing. So I'm kind of taking advantage of that and putting more songs out and than average, just so that they have more content to listen to and so that they can see that I wasn't just sitting around, I was actually building for them and working for them. And it keeps cursing my name. I love my fans very much. Thank you for supporting me. You've not only supported me through the good, but you supported me through my bad times, through my rough times, and my mistakes. So thank you so much for loving me. To my new fans, welcome to the family. You're about to be a part of a journey that's going to be so fun, and I really hope you know that you're going to be involved with and engaged with. I call my fans the A-Team, so welcome to the A-Team. Thank you guys for giving me a chance to have this pedestal and to have this inspiration to you and to make this music, you know. And I love you all. Staying in Paris to get away from your parents. You look so proud. You're standing there with a frown and a cigarette, posting pictures of yourself on the internet. Out on the terrace, we breathe in the air of this small town. On our
wrong cup and cup.